Hey guys, so recently you may have noticed a bit of a shift where businesses just can't get away with posting memes on their account and saying things like tag a friend below who reminds you of this pickle wearing a sombrero. It's a lot more about just creating really engaging content and getting the conversations going and putting the social back in social media. So in this video, I'm gonna go through my process of creating personal and engaging graphics for social media. And next week, I'm also going to be showing you how to turn that graphic into a moving GIF. So make sure to check back in for that. And if you're ready, let's do it. The tool we're going to be using for today's video is canva.com. And it's completely free for you to sign up. Once you do sign up and log in, you will see a screen similar to this one, and you can just start designing things straight away with some templates that Canva has for you. Otherwise, you can start from scratch, which is exactly what we're gonna be doing. But we will be using the square Instagram post dimensions over here. As in this video, we're gonna be creating a multi-image Instagram post, but I'm also going to be showing you how to turn that into a GIF for Facebook next week. So the square post works well, and we're just gonna click on it and jump straight on in. So once you click on any of the categories on the previous screen, you're gonna start with a completely blank page here, and it's going to show you some preset layouts that you can use for creating your graphic. But in this case, we're gonna start from scratch. So we're gonna go and head over to the Elements tab over here, and we're going to place a grid, which is going to allow us to drag and drop an image in here, and it's gonna perfectly center that for us every time. So I'm gonna go to Uploads and bring in the image that I've already uploaded from my computer here. Now, the key to making beautiful and engaging multi-image posts on Instagram as well as GIFs is to tell a story as you're going through it. And I found that the easiest way to do that is to select images that are similar in color scheme or in content. So in this case, I'm going to be using 5 images of myself moving just slightly to kind of tell a story as people are swiping through. So you'll see exactly what I mean once I put all the elements together with my graphic. So I'm going to go ahead and head over back to the Elements tab. And instead of using a grid this time, we're going to go ahead and select shapes over here. So I want to go ahead and select a triangle shape, and I'm going to be using this one down here. And you can do this with any shape, or you can choose not to have any shapes at all in your graphics. But for this purpose, I am going to go ahead and use a triangle and twist it to 45 degrees. I'm gonna place that in the middle so you can see these purple lines are popping up to tell me that I am centered in the middle of my graphic here, which is great. And I'm going to go ahead and make that white in the top left-hand corner here. And I'm also going to change the opacity or the transparency in the top right-hand corner over here. So that looks good. And I'm gonna go ahead and copy that and use it 2 more times in my graphic. Might need to just make it a little bit bigger to squeeze into this corner over here. Now this one's going to be slightly more transparent than the one in the middle, and I'm going to go ahead and copy that once more and rotate that over here and place it in the bottom right hand corner over here. So that looks good. And now I'm going to go ahead and add some text. So we're just going to head over to the text section. And I could use any of the pre-made ones over here as well, but I want to start from scratch. And I'm just going to go ahead and move that down straight over my triangle over here. Now I'm going to change the font in the top left-hand corner. So we're going to go with something a little bit more eye-catching. I'm going to choose this one over here, and I'm just going to go ahead and change the text and make it larger by increasing the size over here and making sure to center that back up. So that'll be my first graphic. And now, instead of starting from scratch for the second page and hoping to line things up just right, all I have to do is just duplicate this exact template for my second page by clicking this button over here. And now all I have to adjust is my text and the background image. So I'm gonna go ahead with the second one over here, and this one's gonna say me, and we're gonna duplicate once more and select our third image, keeping in mind that for Instagram's carousel posts, you can use up to 10 images or videos or a mix of both. But for our purpose today, we're just going to be using the 5. So I'm going to go ahead and replace this image. And this time we're just going to go with some question marks. And one last one. I'm just going to use this image and exclamation points. Now in this instance, what I'm trying to do is grab my audience's attention and get them to read the caption for more details about a Facebook Live or an Instagram Live, depending on which one I'm doing with this. And that is where I would then give them more details about the time and the platform that I'll be going live on and maybe the topic that we're going to be discussing in our live session. So you don't have to provide them with all the details in the graphic itself and get them to pay a lot more attention to your captions and to the links in your actual Instagram bios as well. So in the bottom right hand corner here, I'm going to jump into presentation mode so that I can show you what this might look like when someone's actually scrolling through it on their Instagram feed. All right, so next week we're going to be turning these into GIFs that you can use for your Facebook page. And once again, you can then put all the details about the actual live event in the description that's associated with the GIF. So I'll definitely see you there. But if you wanted to go ahead and turn this into a beautiful multi-image post on Instagram, all you would have to do is add a heading. And then hit download, and you could download it as a PNG file or a JPEG. Hit download, and then it's going to save straight to your computer, allowing you to send it straight to your phone and start creating some beautiful, captivating multi-image posts on your Instagram account. So I hope you guys really enjoyed that mini tutorial, and if you'd like to learn more about some awesome tips and tools that you can use to really up your online presence, definitely check out the link in the description for your access to our design school. And if you like this video, remember to like it, subscribe to our channel, and let me know what you thought in the comments. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, keep creating the life you love.